My guest today is Tab Hunter, my heartthrob when I was young, and a very famous actor. Hi.
How are you? Thank you for having me on board.
But I feel fortunate to have you. Being famous and being handsome, did you ever feel your real self, your internal self, was invisible to people because all they noticed was your beauty and your fame?
I never wanted people to see what I was like.
Really?
No, because I was frightened of... My sexuality had me really in spins. You know, I just didn't know where the hell I was. I was very fearful of everything. And, of course, being, you know, in motion pictures at that time at a studio under contract to Warner Brothers, you know, the end of the whole studio era with all that hoopla is being thrown out there, you know, hundreds of magazines and television shows and all of that stuff. It's overwhelming for a young man.
But what about the ice skating? When did that happen?
Well, yeah, I went with a friend of mine, Terry Marsteller, to the Polar Palace and met some kids there and joined the Los Angeles Figure Skating Club. And
you skated with the Ice Capades.
Well, I did a couple of specials with them, and then I did a show called Meet Me in St. Louis for Hallmark Hall of Fame with Dick Button. It was called Hans Brinker and the Silver Skates, and I skated in that. Was a show directed by Sidney Lumet, which was a, you know, wonderful experience.
Yeah, what kind of music did you guys have?
Oh, the music of the time, well, when I was growing up, there was a lot of, like, the Andrew Sisters, you know, Don't Fence Me In was big at the barn.
Oh, give me land, lots of land under starry skies. Don't fence me in.
Spade Cooley, Shame, Shame on You.
Shame, shame on you. Shame on you. Gave my heart as a token. When returned, it was broken. Hide your face. Shame on you.
Dinah Washington. I love Dinah.
What a difference a day made. 24 little hours. What the sun and the flowers, where there used to be rain.
I sang at St. Paul's parochial school. I was in the choir there. But I always loved singing. And when Natalie Wood and I were on tour for a film called The Burning Hills, we were in Chicago, and Howard Miller was a huge disc jockey. He could break a record wide open. And he said, I think you should record if you have any interest and if you can carry a tune. He introduced me to Randy Wood of Dot Records. Randy heard me sing, gave me a tune called Young Love.
Which was huge.
It became number one song in the nation. And
I know the bar.
They say for every boy and girl, there's just one love in this whole world. And I know I found mine. The heavenly touch of your embrace tells me no one could take your place.
On a Saturday, and by Monday morning, I was driving my car down Sunset Boulevard and almost ran into a palm tree. I thought, oh my God, that's me coming out of the car radio.
Young love, first love,
first love,
filled with true devotion. Young love, our love,
first love,
we share with emotion.
The studio wouldn't always let you do the things you really wanted. It was the end of the studio era. For example, studios were falling apart. Television was coming in a big way. Audiences were changing. It was younger audiences. Families were staying at home.
Right, yeah.
So consequently, Warner Brothers would loan me out to a lot of different television shows. But the studio owned you and would lease you out to Harry Cohn at Columbia for, say, I did Gunman's Walk over there with Van Heflin, or Paramount. I did a film with Sophia Loren. Because if there was nothing there for you at the studio, they would loan you out and consequently, you know, make money.
But it made you famous when you kissed Linda Darnell, didn't it?
Island of Desire, my first starring film. I walked into the office, the director and the writer looked at me, Stephanie Nordley, and she said, that's the boy I want.
Really?
just like that.
I knew that.
Then I had to go and, oh my gosh, you know, how do I read my new name off a piece of paper? But I had to screen test with Linda, and I was a nervous wreck. And she was so wonderful. She said, "Tab, relax. I'm good luck for newcomers." And then I had to take her in my arms and kiss her in the scene. And I thought, oh my God, I've got to kiss the Blessed Mother from the Song of Bernadette. It was very, she was wonderful to me. She pinched me and she said, "That was nice," after the kiss. And she said, "And just remember this, I'm good luck for newcomers."
You met someone that always fascinated me as a young girl, and that was Tony Perkins. Were you taken with him immediately?
I was impressed with the fact that he was a New York actor. And I just admired anyone from New York because I was a product of Hollywood. We saw a great deal of each other. I respected him tremendously. He was a fine, fine actor. He was very complex. And then Merv Griffin was the one who told me about Battle Cry. Merv said, "You should have your agent check into this role." Made 9 tests for Battle Cry, and Warner Brothers exercised an option to put me under contract, but they did not put me under contract until 2 films later.
And you were now in the movie business, and you were singing.
Music was a very important part of my life. The stable years when I was out at the barn, there were great songs there. There were great songs all through my, you know, all through that period.
What kind of songs did you like when you were, like, acting?
Every time I would go to New York, I'd see everything on Broadway. I love Broadway musicals. They were great.
What was your favorite?
So I'm a little partial there because Warner Brothers bought Damn Yankees for me, and I did Damn Yankees. But I love The King and I love Oklahoma. I used to love musicals.
But during this time, you also did another famous song, which is I'll Be With You.
Oh, an Apple Blossom Time. You know, I was at Dot Records when I would cut Young Love, and Warner's hit the ceiling. They said, Jack Warner said, "Wait a minute, we own you for everything." So they stopped me from releasing an album that I had a huge advance on from Dot. They stopped everything after just a few records. And finally, they decided to do Warner Brothers Records. And I was the first artist on the Warner Brothers label. And Apple Blossom Time was the song.
One day in May,
also did 99 Ways.
Yeah, that was a fun song. I liked it. It was very kind of Guy Mitchell type of a tune.
There must be 99 ways of losing the blues that I got from loving you. 99 ways, but I still love you. Yes, I do. Yes, 99 ways, but I still love you.
A CD of your music was released.
Yeah, The Best of Tab Hunter, they released that. And it's got stuff I did on the Dot label and stuff I did on the Warner Brothers label. You know, I mean, I've got some good tunes that meant something to me.
Thank you so much for being with me.
Alyce, thank you. I've really enjoyed it.
They say for every boy and girl, there's just one love in this whole world. And I know, I found mine. The heavenly touch of your embrace tells me no one could take your place ever in my heart. Young love, first love, filled with true devotion. Young love. Ja.
just one kiss from your sweet lips will tell me that your love is real, and I can feel that it's true. We will vow to one another, there will never be another love for you or for me. Young love, first love, filled with true devotion. Young love, our love, we share with deep emotion.